You're listening to the audio production of Midnight Dad Devotional, 100 Devotions and Prayers to Connect Dads Just Like You to the Father, by Dr. Mark Pitts and Becky Thompson, published by Thomas Nelson and read by the authors.
For my wife Susan, who has been my best friend for more than 40 years, thank you for your encouragement and support throughout the creation of this book. For my daughter Becky, who reminds me every day that I don't have to be afraid to chase a dream, thank you for showing me the way to get where I was going. Mark.
For my dad, Mark Pitts, who has lived out the message of this book, I learned the Father's love through yours. Here's our Becky.
Introduction. To you, Dad, before we begin, I'm not sure how this book came to be in your possession. I'm not sure what you were looking for or what someone you love was thinking when this book was purchased. What I do know is what you'll find inside. Our prayer is that each of these 100 devotions connects you to the heart, wisdom, and strength of your Father in heaven. That's the mission we've been assigned. Who are we? I am Dr. Mark Pitts, Becky Thompson's dad. We co-wrote this book together. I met and married my wife, Susan, while I was attending the University of Tulsa College of Law, where I earned a Juris Doctorate degree. I have two grown daughters, Beth and Becky, of course. Together, we have been in part-time or full-time ministry for 38 years, establishing and planting churches and starting dozens of new ministries.
And I'm Becky Thompson. A few years ago, I began a nightly prayer ministry online called Midnight Mom Devotional, reaching out to moms all across the world. Soon, I invited my mom, Susan, to help me lead this ministry. Each night, with a short devotion and prayer, we connected women to each other and the hope of Jesus. Not surprisingly, as a family, we began to feel as though the mission of this ministry was expanding to create a space to reach dads as well. And so, the Midnight Dad Devotional was created long before you held this book in your hands. We've been praying for dads just like you for years now in our online community.
However, I didn't want to limit this work to just a set of nightly prayers. Instead, I wanted to give dads an opportunity to see themselves in the words of Scripture. I wanted them to understand that, with the exception of Jesus, God has always used ordinary people to do remarkable things. That's where you come in, Dad. You are a man God can use. God knows we are imperfect, and the sooner we dads recognize that fact, the sooner we can exchange those imperfections for His goodness. And isn't that what you really want? To be more like Him and still rest in His peace, His security, and His blessing? I want you to see yourself in these biblical examples and believe that you have, or can have, God's love safely and securely in your heart. At the same time, I don't want you to settle. I hope you realize there is always a better or a best to the good you already are. God has called you to the role of Father, and you have God Himself as a role model. All these devotions and prayers are intended to draw you closer to God's heart. He is, of course, the perfect Father, and He wants you to come up higher and closer to His standard. The examples in this book are intended to show you that you are already on that journey, and you can make it. We are praying for you as you begin. Dr. Mark Pitts
and Becky Thompson.
Chapter 1. Tonight we pray for the dad who knows God as his Father. Dad, as we embark on our journey of discovering our role as fathers, the most important thing we can understand is that we, ourselves, have a Heavenly Father who loves us, cares for us, and provides for us, just as we love, care for, and provide for our children. By understanding God as Father, we understand who we are as dads. Jesus taught us about knowing our Father. Matthew 6:9 says, "This then is how you should pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name." Take notice. Jesus didn't say, "My Father." He didn't say, "O God, creator of the universe." He said to his disciples and to us to pray to God as though we have a personal relationship with him. At the time these words were spoken, this was a seismic shift in the people's understanding of God. This was the first time in Scripture anyone had been taught to pray to God as their own Father. The people could only understand that God was God. Jesus expanded the people's hearts to believe exactly who God could be to them, a dad. The same may be true for us. We have been taught that God is God, but we forget he is our Father. So, dad, a note right here at the beginning. You have a Father. In every circumstance, every trial, he is waiting to hear from you. He wants to hear your heart. As you go through these devotionals, daily, weekly, or however often you enter in, remember that you can look to him, your dad, to carry you through whatever you are facing. He wants every good thing for you, just as you want every good thing for your children. And more than anything, he wants to connect with your heart. Let's pray. Lord, as this dad prays to you in the words that Jesus taught us to pray, "Our Father in heaven," help him understand the true meaning of that relationship. Help him to know the joy and the power and the goodness of that relationship. As you reveal yourself in these next 99 teachings, help him capture what is in your heart so he can be the best dad for his children by better knowing you as his Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Continue the connection. Take a moment to pray the Lord's Prayer. It is found in Matthew chapter 6, verses 9 through 13. Chapter 2. Tonight we pray for the dad who has questions. It's okay to have questions about the things Jesus taught and said and did. After all, the events in the Gospels took place about 2,000 years ago. There were different customs, different cultures, and different ways to look at the world. Sometimes, as a modern man, it can be difficult to understand everything that was happening. It was okay then, and it's okay now, to ask questions. There was one such man in Scripture named Nicodemus, who had many questions. He was a renowned teacher in Israel who believed that God had said everything that needed to be said in the Old Testament writings. He lived his life teaching this concept. For most of his life, he was certain he was correct, until Jesus of Nazareth came. The Scripture says, "Now there was a Pharisee, a man named Nicodemus, who was a member of the Jewish ruling council. He came to Jesus at night and said, 'Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher who has come from God, for no one could perform the signs you are doing if God were not with him.'" John 3:1-2. Nicodemus wanted to know from Jesus just how he came from God. They had a lengthy conversation, which included the famous words, "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life." Verse 16. Nicodemus asked his questions, and Jesus gave his answers. There is no other recorded contact between them. Listen, Dad, while it is okay to ask questions, what you do with the answers is even more important. When you receive your answers, allow them to bring you closer to the Lord. Allow your story to be richer and deeper. Allow the answers to change your life as well. Let's pray. Lord, sometimes this dad has questions, and he wants answers. He believes that only you have the real answers to the questions in his life. Just as any good father stands ready to answer the honest questions of his child, so you desire to answer your children. Show him that you are never out of his reach. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Continue the connection. What are you bringing to Jesus this week? What answers are you listening for? Chapter 3. Tonight we pray for the dad who is always prepared. When you think of the word prepared, what comes to mind? You probably think about having the right equipment or knowledge or attitude. Preparation looks different for each of us, but I'd define it this way. Preparation is the soul of success. When it comes to being a dad, you have prepared all of your life for the opportunity to lead, guide, and direct a family. It's your responsibility. You know it. Whether or not you were raised in a home where your dad prepared every day to make a way for his family, you feel the weight of it for yours. You want to be able to say that with Christ's help, you've done your best in all circumstances that day, that you've left nothing out, that when the lights are out and it's quiet and just before you fall asleep, you know that this day and everything else associated with it is complete. Isn't that what you really want? That's why you prepare. Scripture reminds us in Proverbs 16, verse 9, "A man's heart plans his way, but the Lord directs his steps." We must understand here that it is the Lord who provides the goal, sets the vision, and determines the outcome. While we can and should make our plans, no plans should be made without our Heavenly Father's influence. So also, while we do our part to prepare our lives, we cannot overlook the importance of looking to God to prepare our hearts and minds. He knows what's up ahead. We bring our best offering. He takes the desires of our hearts and wraps them in wisdom and grace. Together, we can face anything. Let's pray. Lord, this dad has learned that the better he prepares for each day, the easier that day progresses, the more he achieves, and the more successful he feels. He looks to you to prepare his heart and mind. Give this dad who has already prepared for tomorrow a good night's sleep with the peace he richly deserves. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Continue the connection. As you pray this week, what is it that you are preparing for that you need God's help with in order to succeed? He is more than willing to meet you at the place of your need and walk you through it. Chapter 4. Tonight we pray for the dad who is wise. In Matthew chapter 7, verses 24 through 27, Jesus shared a story of two homes. "Everyone who hears these words of mine and puts them into practice is like a wise man who built his house on the rock. The rain came down, the streams rose, and the winds blew and beat against that house, yet it did not fall, because it had its foundation on the rock. But everyone who hears these words of mine and does not put them into practice is like a foolish man who built his house on sand. The rain came down, the streams rose, and the winds blew and beat against that house, and it fell with a great crash." You have likely heard this story before. It's an obvious analogy that is easy for us to apply to our lives. We build our families on the hope of Jesus as the rock, and when life's storms come, we are able to withstand them. Those who heard this story at the time of Jesus telling it understood a much deeper meaning. When Jesus shared these words, building a house on sand was easier, cheaper, and so much quicker. A house constructed on sand could be built all at once. But this house was always in danger of collapse. A house built on a rock required much more planning, and because of the additional costs, it could often be built only in stages. As wise dads, we must remember both lessons. We must choose to build our lives on Jesus and His Word, but we must also remember that we choose to build this life day by day, season by season, segment by segment. This is the lifestyle of a wise dad. Daily we choose small, solid victories rather than an easy out, knowing that when we do, we won't have to fear collapse. Let's pray. Lord, you know that this dad wants to protect his children, and this requires wise choices to move forward. Help him be careful to weigh the risks and take small steps if necessary, rather than losing a lot. Your plans are safe, and this dad's family has peace because they know you have provided exactly what they need in every season to build for this moment. Bless this wise dad. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Continue the connection. As you pray this week, think about the small victories that have led up to large successes in your life. What were some of them? Chapter 5. Tonight we pray for the dad who needs a miracle.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.